Good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's episode of the Great Commission. Thank you for joining us in the studio today. And to all the viewers at home, thank you for joining us. Today, we have three very special guests with us. First up, we have the man who led the Israelites out of Egypt and who parted the Red Sea. Please welcome Moses. Your commission, the Great Commission, which was given to us by God. So we want to find out about the difficulties and the challenges that you face trying to carry out God's plan of salvation. Let's start with Moses. So Moses, one of the very first tasks assigned to you by God was to lead his people, the Israelites, out of Egypt and out of slavery. Can you tell us your experience in convincing the elders to leave Egypt and out of the desert?
Thank you for inviting me to come today to answer your question. It wasn't easy, you know. I think everybody here knows my story and my background, so I won't get into that. But when God informed me that I had to approach the elders of Israel, I remember telling God, what if they will not believe me or listen to me? Maybe they will say, that's not true, God did not appear to you, but God equipped me with signs so that they would believe me.
That's fascinating. Can you tell us briefly what signs God equipped you with?
Surely God granted me a staff which could turn into a serpent and back again.
Okay.
He also gave me the power to cure leprosy and to turn water from the Nile into blood.
Okay, so with these signs, the Israelites were then able to believe you?
By the grace of God, mostly yes.
Amen. We also know from your story that you not only had to face the Israelites, but you were also commissioned to persuade Pharaoh to set the Israelites free. Brothers and sisters, let us now turn to the screen to watch a video to look at what Moses had to go through.
Let my people go.
The slaves are mine. Lives are mine. All that they own is mine. I do not know your God, nor will I let Israel go.
Who are you to make their lives bitter in hard bondage? Man shall be ruled by law, not by the will of other men.
Who is this God that I should let your people go?
Aaron, cast down my staff before Pharaoh, that he may see the power of God. In this you shall know that the Lord is God.
Mother! Mother! He turned his staff into a cobra!
Nothing of his will harm you, my son.
The power of your God is a cheap magician's trick. Join us.
Thank you. see?
Whose serpent swallows up the others?
Wow, Moses, to have such audacity, such boldness approaching Pharaoh like that must have been quite daunting. Can you tell us how you managed to do it?
What you saw in the video was only the beginning. That has to be so many more signs before Pharaoh finally let us go free. God hardened the heart of Pharaoh, who continued to refuse to believe in God despite the many great signs and tragedies that befell the Egyptians. Some of these signs were that the river Nile turned to blood, the plague of the frogs, mosquitoes, locusts, the death of livestock, the hail, and the death of all firstborn males in Egypt, including Pharaoh's own.
So after escaping the Egyptians and parting the Red Sea, you still had to lead the Israelites through the desert for 40 years. That sounds like such an arduous task, having to manage the 12 tribes of Israel. Can you share with us your experiences in the desert, in particular, how difficult it was to lead the Israelites?
When we get into the desert, thus the difficulties intensify. You know from my story, the struggles I had to go through with the people who gave me no support and who were always grumbling and complaining. Let me share with you an example. Some of the people actually came up and told me, why did you take us out of Egypt to die in the desert? At least when we were in Egypt, even though we were slaves, we still had food to eat and a roof over our heads. And another example, my dear sister, when they were thirsty, they grumbled and asked, why did you make us leave Egypt to have us die of thirst with our children and our cattle? I didn't know what to do with them anymore. They were almost ready to stone me, but God permitted me to perform another miracle with the staff He equipped me with. God instructed me to strike the rock at Horeb, and water flowed out from it for the people to drink. He also gave manna from heaven to sustain His people.
I think a lot of leaders can relate to you, Moses. But we also know that this was just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to the difficulties you had to encounter with the people God sent you to. Despite all this and more, how could you persist in your commission? What advice would you give to someone who may be going through some similar struggles and hardships?
I often find myself asking that question too, especially during the more difficult times. I ask myself that question even more. The only real conclusion that I can arrive at is this. You go simply because the Lord tells you to. And when the Lord tells you to do something, you have to trust that He will not fail you. If God brings you to it, He will lead you through it.
So, Moses, is it really that simple? You went through all the hardship and persevered simply because the Lord tells you to?
Yes, I did it because the Lord tells me to. That is my commission.
That's a very profound statement to end with, Moses. Thank you for your time. Brothers and sisters, let us now turn to Paul. To begin, let's watch a short video again to see how difficult it was for people to accept Paul as God's chosen instrument.
Lord, Ananias, go to the street called Straight. Ask for a man they call Paul of Tarsus.
Paul? But
He beats us. He arrests your followers everywhere. I have chosen him to proclaim my name to the world, to the Gentile, their kings, and the sons of Israel. Go.
Paul, your conversion story is one of the greatest conversion stories, because it was almost instantaneous. Can you tell us more about what happened?
Thank you for having me on the show. When I was blind, God revealed himself and made me believe in my heart that the one I was persecuting was God. So I knew I had to go and preach to the true God, to the Gentiles, so that they too be converted and saved, as God had saved me.
What about the hardships and the challenges that you encountered along the way? It must have been very lonely.
Truly. For most of my commission, I felt very alone. I had been in prison, I'd been flogged, exposed to death again and again. I'd been lashed by the Jews on a number of occasions, beaten with rods, pelted with stones, even shipwrecked. I spent the night and the day in the open sea, and I've been constantly on the move. I've been in dangers from rivers, from bandits, my fellow Jews, the Gentiles, the city, the country, at sea, and even from false believers. I have labored and toiled, and I've often gone without sleep. I have known hunger and thirst, and I've often gone without food. I have been cold and naked. Besides everything else, I face daily the pressure of my concern for all the churches. To add to all of this, I burn inwardly when there are those that are led to sin. I feel weak when my brother is weak.
That's really quite very heavy, Paul. Yet you are still filled with so much zeal and conviction for our Lord. Brothers and sisters, let us now watch another video on Paul's commission and how the Holy Spirit led him to speak about God's love.
No one goes further than Paul. He converts hundreds across the Mediterranean.
Thank you.
But his previous life as a persecutor haunts him.
Paul of Tarsus.
Now we know who you are.
I mean you no harm.
I have friends in Damascus. You paid them a visit. You meant them plenty of harm.
I've changed. I was blind. Now I can see.
Liar.
I did what I did because I was certain I was right. That I knew what God wanted. As you are certain now. But then Jesus came to me. Not in righteous anger or in judgment, but in love. And without love, we are nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It does not boast. It is not proud. It keeps no records of wrongs. It rejoices with the truth. It bears all things. It believes all things. It hopes all things. It endures all things. When everything else disappears, faith, hope, and love remain. But the greatest of these is love.
We can definitely witness the fire of love which ignited and engulfed your heart to reveal God's love to each one of us. Throughout the loneliness and the persecution, you still persevered with much enthusiasm in preaching the truth about God. How did you manage to do that, Paul?
It was through divine revelation. I was saved when in the midst of my blindness, God revealed himself to me. If I must boast, I will boast all the more gladly about my weakness, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weakness, in insults, in hardships, in persecutions, in difficulties. When I am weak, then I am strong. For it is no longer I speak, but Christ who lives in me.
Brothers and sisters, we have heard from Paul, a man filled with much conviction and zeal, a man whom God has sent, whom God has commissioned to build communities and churches from Jerusalem to Rome, a man who took comfort in God alone and who was able to withstand all kinds of suffering because of the simple truth which God has revealed to him, a truth which we all know, but sadly, not many of us are willing to preach such truths in the way we live our lives for fear of rejection or persecution or judgment. Paul, what advice can you give to those who are struggling to live in the truth?
Truth. If you want to live in the truth, you must desire to establish a personal relationship with God. He comes to us in order to send us forth. This sending forth is our mission. We should not feel sad despite the many challenges, difficulties, and sufferings we surely will encounter. To suffer with Christ is to know Christ. That is the joy of mission.
Paul, is it really worth it to go through all that suffering for God?
Yes, and so many more, yes. It is a great honor and glory to serve God. Those who willingly subject themselves to God's most holy service shall have a great grace and freedom of mind. We are all part of the bigger story, the story of God's plan of salvation for the world. We were made for Christ, and our hearts are restless until they find rest in Him. Suffering has always been a part of our commission, and we carry on in service because the simple truth, as echoed Moses earlier, which is, God wills us too. There is no escaping God.
Indeed, we are filled with an interior peace when we align our wills to God's will. Because God loved us first and taught us how to love, we know that He will carry us through the suffering in order to endure until the very end. Thank you very much, Paul, for inspiring us. Brothers and sisters, we now invite the mother of our God and our dearest mother, Mary, to tell us more about how she lived out her call. Mary, thank you again for joining us.
You're welcome.
Is it okay if I call you Mom for the interview? I feel a little ill at ease calling you by your Christian name.
Surely, my child.
So both Moses and Paul were carrying out their commission in a more public sphere. But you, Mom, you carried out your call in a more private capacity. Let's begin by watching a short video on your commission.
Think that the Messiah, the new King of Israel, could be born here?
Greetings, Elizabeth.
Mary, may you be blessed among all women.
He spoke to me too, the angel, in a dream. He told me, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife.
They said the one who is about to be born. They say they have seen stars.
There's already talk that the wise men left because they found what they were looking for.
The king of the Judeans.
I'm the king of the Judeans!
Your son will mean the ruin of many.
God will cast a shadow over you. Those were the words the angel said. He will be king for a reign without end.
The Son of Man will suffer. He will be killed.
Nothing is impossible for him.
The thoughts of all hearts will be revealed.
Nothing is impossible for God.
Mother, rejoice and be happy.
Joseph found it hard to believe that you were pregnant at first, and he wanted to divorce you in secret. Yet you remained faithful to God throughout your life and carried out his plan for you with utmost humility. How did you manage to cope?
After God sent Angel Gabriel to appear to me in a vision, I continued to put my faith in God, trusting that God has a plan for me. And I'm glad that his plan included Joseph for me. I believe that it has always been God's will to have Jesus, his only son and our Savior, to be raised in a loving and holy family with humble beginnings.
I suppose your family, you, Joseph, and Jesus, is what we know as the Holy Family. And as part of the Holy Family, can you tell us more about your role as the mother of our Lord?
Every mother would try their best to bring up their child in a loving and God-fearing environment. My experience with Jesus was no different. As Jesus got older, he began to do things that I could not understand. However, I put my utmost faith and remained obedient to the Word of God. I know that I am the handmaid of the Lord, so I let it be done unto me according to God's will.
Can you tell us more about where the Holy Spirit prompted you to go? And can you tell us about the challenges that you faced?
Certainly. After the news that I would bear the Son of God, I set out for a town in the hills of Judah and entered the house of Zechariah to greet Elizabeth. Then Joseph and I traveled to Bethlehem. Here, I gave birth to Jesus and laid him in a manger. Before and after Jesus' birth, I submitted to Joseph as his wife, trusting that God will always be watching over our safety. One of the most difficult moments of my commission was to watch my son, Jesus, go through his passion and death. But I kept all these things and pondered them in my heart. With utmost faith and trust in God, who will never fail us.
To keep and to ponder, brothers and sisters, let us watch a video of what Mary had to go through at the foot of the cross. Mom, throughout all the pain and destitution, what has helped you stay faithful in your commission?
My faith in God is simple, and I put my whole trust in Him. Because I believe in His truth, my soul proclaims God's greatness. The Great Commission. We hope you enjoyed the show. Let us give a round.